Hello friends, welcome to my channel The Invisible Maths Teacher. Hope you all are doing good and preparing very well for your exams, and wish you all the very best for your exams. Okay, so let's continue with the revision class today. So here the question is, I think this question is very familiar to you all. Okay, you could see such type of questions in the question papers, previous question papers. First one is A, 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to 20, to find the sum of 2, 4, 6 up to 40, and to find the sum of 5, 7, 9 up to 43. So let's do this one. Here, first let's begin with the first one. Okay, here the question is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, 1, 2, 3, etc. up to 20. So here you can see these are natural numbers starting from 1. So we have the formula. So how many natural numbers are here? 20 natural numbers are there. So we already studied the formula is half into last number n into n plus 1. That n plus 1 means 21. So here you have 2 ones and 2 tens. So how do you write? Yes, you have 10 plus 21. Sorry, 10 into 21, which is equal to 210. Okay, now let's move on to the next one. So here we got 210. Here this one. Okay, now next one. 2 plus 4 plus 6 up to 40. B. 2, 4, 6 up to 40. Okay, so here you know that this is multiple of 2, so let me take 2 outside. 2 is common, so we have 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, 2 threes are 6, etc. plus 2 into how much is 40? 2 into 20 is 40. So here we have 2. Don't forget to write this 2, children. Okay. Now look here, children. We have 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to 20. What is the sum of 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to 20? Yes, from the first bit we already have 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to 20 as 210. So here you can write 210. So what is the answer? 420. Okay, this is the answer for second bit, 420. Now moving on to the next one. Next one is very important. Okay, C1. For writing the C type of questions, you have to first write 2, 4, 6, that one. 2, 4, 6, etc. up to 40. You can see why I am writing this one. See, 2 plus how much is 5? 2 plus 3 is 5, 4 plus 3 is 7, 6 plus 3 is 9, 40 plus 3 is 43. That's why I have written the B bit first. Okay, then I'm going to write here 5, 7, 9, etc. up to 43. Okay, now here you can see 2 plus how much is 5? Plus 3. Again 4. Plus 3, 6 plus 3. Similarly, the last one also 40 plus 3. So like this, how many plus 3's will be there? With this term, see, with this 2 plus 4 plus 6, we are adding 3. How many times we are adding 3? Yes, we are adding 20 times, right? 20 times we are adding 3. So with the sum of 2, 4, 6 up to 40, we are adding 3 how many times? 20 times. This is the meaning. Okay, so how do you write this one? 2 plus 4 plus 3, 4 plus 6. Okay, I'll write here once again. 2 plus 4 plus 6 up to 40 plus 3 how many times? 20 times. Okay, so here you know this one, 2 plus 4 plus 6 up to 40, what is the answer? We already got, it is 420. 420 plus 3 into 20 is 60. So what is the answer? 480 is the answer. Okay. Yes, children. Now moving on to the next one. So here you can see the question. Same similar type of question. Okay. 1 + 2 + 3 up to 40. So let's move on to the first one. You have here natural numbers starting from 1. So 1 + 2 + 3 up to 40. So we know there are 40 natural numbers. So sum of 40 natural numbers, 40 is equal to, how do you write? Yes, half into n. N is 20 into n plus 1, that is 41. Then 2 ones are and 2 into 20. So what is the answer? 20 into 41, which is equal to 820. Okay, this is the answer for the first one. So here we can mark here 820. Okay, now next one. Second one. Here you can see that these are multiples of 5. 5 plus 10 plus 15 up to 200. Right? So we know these are multiples of 5. 5 ones are 5. 5 twos are 10, 5 threes are 15, up to how much? 5 into 40, 200. So here we have again natural number starting from 1 up to 40 inside the bracket. That is, we have already from 1 to 40 here. How much? What is the sum of that? 820. So 820 into 5, the answer is 4100. This is the answer. Okay, now next one. Our CBET. Okay. For the CBET, I'm not rubbing off this BBET. 5, 10, 15, 200. You can see here 5 plus 2, 7, 10 plus 2, 12, 15 plus 2, 17, 200 plus 2, 200. By looking to the last number itself, we can understand that maybe this is summing up by 2. Okay, so for better you always check the last number. So here we got plus 2, then you check here whether all these are plus 2 only or not. 5 plus 2 10 plus 2 15 plus 2, like that. Okay, so we understood it is plus 2. So here 7 12 17 up to 202, that is we have plus 2 here, plus 2, plus 2, plus 2, here also plus 2. Okay, so how many plus 2s are there? With this 5, 5, 10, 15, up to 200, plus how many 2s are added? 40 2s are added, right? 40 times 2 is added. So plus 2, how many times? 40 times. We know the sum of this number is already 4100. So I'm writing here 4100 and here you have 80. So what is the answer? 4180. Okay, so here you have 4180. This is the answer. Yes, children, I'm moving on to the third question, which is very interesting. Here you have four bits. Okay, here 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to 60. That is the first bit. Okay, let's move on to that. 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to 60. So we know these are natural numbers starting from 1. So there are 60 terms. So directly we can write 1 by 2 into last number, that is 60 into next number, 61. So 2 ones are and 2 into 30 is 60. So what is the answer? We have 30 into 61, which is equal to 1830. Okay, I'm writing here 1830. Now moving on to the next one. Okay. Okay. B bit. 4 8 12 4 8 12 up to 240. Yes, what does this look like? Isn't it a multiple of 4? Yes, that is 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8, 4 threes are 12, up to 4 into 6 is 24. So 4 into 60 is 240. See here, 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to 60. Already we got the answer, that is 1830. 1830. So what is the answer? 4 into 1830, which is equal to 7320. This is the answer. 7320. Okay. Now next one, CBIT. Okay, CBIT, just compare the last two terms here, 240 and 241. Just one is added, right? 240 plus 1 is 240. Now let us check for the other numbers. 4 plus 1, 5, 8 plus 1, 9, 12 plus 1, 13. Yeah, fine. Now it is good. So we have 4, 8, 12 up to 240. And the next one is 5, 9, 13. Up to 241. Okay, so now we understood that always 1 is added here. Plus 1, plus 1, plus 1, here plus 1. So that means with 4, 8, 12, 240. 4, 8, 12, up to 240. What we are adding? Yes, we are adding 1. How many times? 60 times we are adding. So we already got 4 plus 8 plus 12 up to 240. Answer is 7320 plus 1 into 60 is 60. So what is the answer? 7380. Okay. 7380. Now moving on to the last one. Okay. Last one, from the CBIT, let us check out. Okay, 5, 9, 13, up to 241. And here we have 9, 17, 25, up to 481. Here you can see that 5 plus how much is 9? 4. 9 plus how much is 17? 8 plus 8. Okay, then take another color. Nine plus 8, 13 plus 12. Similarly, 241 plus how much is 481? 240. Understood. So that means with this 5, 9, 13, etc. up to 241, what we are adding? Yes, we are adding 4 plus 8 plus 12 up to 240 to get this one. Understood. With 5, 9, 13, etc., we are adding 4, 8, 12 up to 240 to get 9, 17, 25, etc. So how much is the answer for 5 plus 9 plus 13? We already have it is 7380 plus. What is 4 plus 8 plus 12 plus up to 240? It is 7320. Okay, so what is the answer we have? This is the answer, 14,700. So you can write here 14,700. Yeah, moving on to one more example. Okay, 1, 2, 3 up to 100. So we know now this is already natural numbers starting from 1, that is S of 100 is equal to half into, yes, how do you write? Last number into next number, 2 ones and 2 fifties. So you have 50 into 101 is equal to 5050. Okay, so I'm writing here 5050. Now next one. Okay. B1, B-bit. What does this look like? Multiple of 3. So I'm take 3 outside. 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6, 3 threes are 9. 3 into how much is 300? 3 × 100 is 300. So we have 1 + 2 + 3 up to 100. Already we got it from Abit. What is the answer? 5050. So 3 × 5050 is 15150. That is the answer. Okay. Now next one, our C bit. Okay. C1 is 13, 16, 19 up to 310. These are not multiples of any number. Okay, so let us check out the last one. 300 + 10 is 310. Now let us check if it is +10 or not. 3 + 10 = 13. 6 + 10 = 16. 9 + 10 = 19. So always 10 is added. So with this 3 + 6 + 9 up to 300, 10 is added to get 13. Again 10 is added to get 16. Again 10 is added to get 19. Similarly here also 10 is added to get 310. That means with this 3, 6, 9 up to 300, what is added? 10 is added. How many times? 100 times, right? 100 times 10 is added. So what is the answer? How much is 3 + 6 + 9? We have 15150, and 10 × 100 is 1000. So the answer is 16150. Okay. Okay. Now next one. D bit. For D bit, let us consider our C bit, okay? 13, 16, 19 up to 310. 12, 15, 18 up to 309. Look at the last terms, it is subtracting 1, right? 310 - 1. Now let us check here. 13 - 1 = 12. 16 - 1 = 15. 19 - 1 = 18. That means always -1 is added. So let us try with 13, 16, 19 up to 310. We are adding -1 how many times? 100 times. Taking -1 100 times. So what is the sum of 13 + 16 + 19? 16150 minus 1 × 100 is 100. So what is the answer? 16050. Okay, 16050. This is how you have to do. Okay. Yes, children. Now here, moving on to statistics question. This is very important one where usually children make mistake. Okay, here you can see the use of electricity in units given: 80 to 90, 90 to 100, 100 to 110, 110 to 120, 120 to 130, and 130 to 140. And the number of houses. That is, 3 houses are consuming 80 to 90 units. 6 houses, this one, 7 houses, 10, 9, 5 houses, like that. So whenever such class intervals are given, we understood that we don't know the exact value of units they are consuming. Understood? Class interval is given. These 3 houses, they are using in between 80 to 90, but we don't know how much it is, like that. So here, always try to make 4 columns where I already prepared the 3rd column here. You can see here. See the 3rd column. I wrote the first number as it is 3, then keep adding the numbers: 6 + 3 = 9, 9 + 7 = 16, 16 + 9 = 26, 26 + 9 = 35, 35 + 5 = 40. Then the next one will be probability column. That is 3 by 40, 9 by 40, 16 by 40, 26 by 40, 35 by 40, and last 40 by 40. Okay. Now, let me read up the question. If the houses are arranged according to the increasing order of consumption, which house comes in the middle? Which house comes in the middle? And in which class it belongs to? Again, I'm repeating, if the houses are arranged according to the increasing order of consumption, which house comes in the middle and in which class it belongs to? So here we have two questions. That is, they're asking you that if the houses are arranged in the increasing order. Okay, so here already it's arranged in the increasing order because this is the order. This is the increasing order. So that question usually makes confusion for the children. So please, children, try to ignore that confusion. Okay, whenever such questions are asked, like if they are arranged in the increasing order, keep in mind that that is already set here. You don't have to rewrite this again and again. Understood? It's already set. What you have to do is just find the middle position. Understood? So let us see who is that middle house. So for that, how do we do? Yeah, we have the middle position. Middle position is equal to, we know the formula, n plus 1 by 2. That is 40 plus 1 by 2. What is that? 41 by 2. How much is 41 by 2? 20.5. So 20.5 means we have 20 here and 21 here. That means the houses in the 20th and 21st position, they both are in the middle position. Okay, so you can write 20th and 21st. Now you can see here in which class interval they belongs to. So we have the first answer as 20th and 21st house are in the middle position. Okay, 20th and 21st houses are in the middle position. Now what is their class interval? We have two bits in that A itself. You have two bits like this. Okay. Yeah, what is the class interval of them? Here you have the class till here, it is 16 houses. From here starts your 17th house. From 17 to 26th the house comes here. So what is their class interval? 110 to 120. 110 to 120. This is their class. Okay, class interval. Now moving on to the second bit of the question, which is very important, and at the same time children usually make mistake here. Okay, the question is, if the consumptions in the median class are in an arithmetic sequence, what is the consumption of 17th house? Of the 17th house, what is the consumption of electricity of the 17th house? Look here, children. Here there are three houses. Here from 4th house to 9th house. Here from 10 to 16. From here, see this one, from 10 to 16, from here 17 to 26, from here 27 to 35, from here 36 to 40. Understood? It goes like this. Here 1, 2, 3, here 4 to 9. Understood? So 17th house means here. 17th house is here. So here what you do is, first you find out this number. 120 minus 110. What is the answer? 10. Now find the difference between this one also. 26 minus 16. That is also equal to 10. Then what to do is, this 10 divided by this 10. What is the answer? 1. Now take half of that, is equal to 0.5. Understood? That is 120 minus 110 is 10. 26 now forget this one. Okay, children, always forget this one. This is just for your question, that's all. Now you have 26 minus 16, that is again 10. Then 10 by 10 is half, is 1. Again take half of it, you have 0.5. now for the 17th person, that is 17th house, that is the first house. What is the number here? First number, 110. See, 17 is the first house in this line, 110. With that 110, you have to just add 0.5, so you will get 110.5 units. Okay, this is how you have to do. Now moving on to median, that is usually the third bit of the question. Okay, for that we already got the middle position as 20.5. so 20.5 lies between this one only. and this number itself. Okay, and this one 20, right? Our middle position was 20.5. now how to do is just make a box like this. Write here x and here half probability. Okay, half. Okay, x. Write here 110 and here 120. Similarly here 16/40 and down 26/40. Probability half. Okay, now x minus 110 divided by 120 minus 110. Okay, next half minus 16/40 and 26/40 minus 16/40. X minus 110 divided by 10 is equal to just, okay, different denominators. So 2 into 40 is 80, then 40 into 1, 40 minus 16 into 2, 32. Moving down, denominators are same. So 40 and numerators will be 26 minus 16 only. Okay, so next step, x minus 110 by 10 is equal to, yes, 80. 40 minus 32 is 8 and this is 10/40. Okay, so x minus 110, x minus 110 by 10 is equal to 8/80 into, when you change this you will have 40 divided by 10. Okay, so this one always you can cancel like this, 192, one time and two times. Then now here also you can cancel one time and four times. This is enough. By 10 is equal to 4/10. Bring this by 10 to the other side, it becomes into 10. Okay, 4/10 into 10, 10 cancels. So you have x minus 110 is equal to 4. So x is equal to 4 plus 110, which is equal to 114. This is the median units. Okay, yes children, another example. Okay, here daily wages are given and the number of workers. So 400 to 500 rupees 6 workers are getting. We don't know exactly how much they are getting, but 6 workers are getting between these wages. Then from 500 to 600, 7 people are getting. 600 to 700, 10 people are getting. So it goes like this. So first we have to write the order. Okay, that is first is 6 people. 6 plus 7, 13, 13 plus 10, 23, 23 plus 9, 32, 32 plus 5, 37, 37 plus 4, 41. Okay, so this is the order. Now here we have 6/41, 13/41, 23/41, 32/41, 36/41 and 41/41. So first let me read out the questions. Okay, so the question is, in which class 21st worker comes? In which class does the 21st worker comes? So we know that here from 1 to 6 workers, then from 7 to 13 in this one, then 14 to 23, 24 to 32, 33 to 37 and 38 to 41. This is the order. So 21st worker will come in this class interval, that is 600 to 700. Then next one is, what is the wage of 14th worker in the arrangement? That is, in this set of arrangement, what is the wage of the daily wage of the 14th worker? So we can, you can see that 14 is coming in this one. Right here 14 is coming, that is the first worker in this third column is 14th worker. Okay, so here let us see how to do this one. For that we have to consider this one and this one. Okay, So here we have 700 minus 600. How much it is? 100. And this one, 23 minus 13. That is 10. So 100 divided by 10. How much is 100 divided by 10? 10. Now take half of this 10. That is 5. Okay, now keep it as this. Now 14th worker means the first worker. So what is the first wage written here? 600. So with the 600, you just add 5. 605. That is the assumed wage of the 14th worker. This is how you have to do. Okay, this is the type of question that is usually not familiar to some of the students. Okay, they usually, you get confused when they ask a particular worker or particular child or a particular house or something, you might get confused. So this is how you have to do. Understood? Now if they are asking you for the 15th worker, 15th worker means just the second worker. So with the 600, you have to just add one more 5. 600 is 14th worker plus 5. That is for the 14th worker. So for 15th worker, just add one more 5. So you will get 610. Understood? Then for 16th worker, you have to just add one more 5. You have to do like that. Okay? Children, this part of the question is done by me. So the next part of the question, okay, that is to find the middle worker, find the middle worker and find the median wage. Okay, find the middle worker. Who is the middle worker? Which position is the middle worker standing at? And find the median wages. Okay, you can use the method you have studied in your school, or you can follow the method which I showed you just now in the previous question. Okay, yes children, if you found this video useful, please do share, subscribe and press on the bell icon for getting the notifications. Thank you.